This presentation is going to quickly take you through the process of getting started with Google Sites. And we're going to do a few things here. The first is we're going to go through creating a Google site using your Google account and choosing a theme for that site. We'll talk about creating pages within Google Sites or subpages within the main site. We'll talk about site structure, which is the main landing page, as well as categories of pages that you'll have in there, and then creating specific pages within those categories. And then we'll talk about how to work with navigation. So once you have a bunch of pages, how do you actually get to them? And that will in large part be about creating a menu bar and adjusting and customizing that menu bar.
So the first thing we need to do, of course, is to actually go to Google Sites. And you can do this from google.com. You can just click on this little box up here, and that'll send you to the Google Apps. And notice that Sites isn't on here. You have to go to More to get to it, just like Google Scholar and other things like that. But the easiest way for me is just to type in sites.google.com, and that will bring you to your account. If you're already signed into any Google Apps, Drive, Gmail, YouTube, it'll go ahead and sign you in, but otherwise you should go ahead and sign in yourself. Okay, so here I've already created a site, but I want to go through and show you how to do it. So I'm going to click on Create, and then always choose blank template, or I always like to choose blank template. You can customize any of these things later on, and certainly you can create another site like this and actually see how they've done it in case you can't figure out how to do something or look up another tutorial or something like that. And I'm going to name my site just my name, so Ted Gournelos, and you can see that it looks like this. However, if I want to name it so that it actually looks right, I can do that, and notice it still makes the URL the same, lowercase and with no spaces. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it like this. You can select a theme if you wish, but I would recommend just keeping it regular, blank, because again, you can change all of this later on if you choose to. So don't worry about that. And then in terms of options, you can add a description, and you know, you can do that if you choose to. Again, we can always change it later. And then you need to type in these letters here and click on Create. I'm going to cancel because I've already got a site here. So this is what happens when you have no template and everything is very basic. You can see we've got a navigation here that we can see. We've got our header here. We've got a sidebar. We've got what the actual page is. And so home is the page we're on. And this is what's said here. There's a header for the page. And then we've got a bottom bar here. So the one thing that will look different for me and for you is that I've got a little page here called social media. And I'm going to go through a few things and show you how to edit some of the stuff. But the first thing is I want to show you how to view this as a viewer. So preview page as viewer actually shows you what the page looks like for somebody else coming in. And notice the difference here. We don't have this header bar. So I'm going to go ahead and close this. And then let's start messing around with the process of creating the site. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually show you how to create a page. So we just click on New Page. And then you can call it what you want. So let's say we're gonna do research here, right? And again, you can see the URL and you can change this if you choose to. And this is going to be a web page for me. And you can choose to put it at the top level, meaning that it will show up on the menu bar as a regular menu item, or you can put it under home. And I'm gonna put it at the top level. So create. And you can see here's my research page, and now I've got home, research, social media, and then the sitemap. And again, all of this is customizable. So I'm gonna go ahead and save this. And so we have a bunch of options now to deal with in general. So I'm gonna go to just worrying about site structure first, but maybe let's play with a couple more pages here. So what I'm gonna do is go to edit site layout. And notice here we have a bunch of options. And here's where you're gonna play with a lot of things in terms of what you want it to look like. So we've got right now a sidebar, my horizontal navigation. We've got our header, which is this right here. And then we've got the page header. So I can take off the header and you can see what it looks like. I'm gonna leave that on because that's where I would put a logo and things like that. Right now it's really ugly and you can click on it to edit it. Right, so you can add in a logo and all that kind of stuff. You can change your theme and whatever you want to do. But for right now, I'm not going to worry about any of that. And you can go through and you can change your sidebar, etc. So Right now, I'm going to go ahead and edit my sidebar, and you can say, oh, on the left, on the right, how big it is, etc. Right? And you can do it as a horizontal navigation instead, which is usually what I prefer, which is to have it up here as opposed to on the side. And you can do both if you choose to, but I think that's kind of silly. I don't think that's really necessary most of the time. So if we take off our sidebar, you can see that we have it just at the top here. Notice that those other pages are missing, right? So I'm going to go ahead and close this. And so again, here we have home, and I'm going to go to manage site. And so here we have a bunch of different options. We can go to pages, and we can see I've got three pages here. We can see what attachments we have. We can see our templates. All sorts of stuff that we can deal with. You can certainly see sharing and permissions, which would allow me to make this public or not. And then themes, colors, and fonts, where you can do a lot of customization, and we're going to worry about that later. Notice that in sharing and permissions, you want to keep this public or have it so that anybody with the link can view it, because I certainly need to be able to see your site. So let's get out of this. And let's look at things a couple more. So we can go to page settings here, and you can see show page title, show links, allow attachments, allow comments, and you can do a page description. So the first thing I want to take off is page title, because I don't think that looks very good. So you can see right now, the standard is just that I've got my whatever page will appear is here at the bottom, and then I've got my navigation here. So I'm going to go through and do a couple of other little things here. So I'm going to edit my site layout again. And then I'm going to go to scroll over my horizontal navigation, click on it, and then it will show me which pages I want to show. And right now I want to add a page. And I'm going to add research, and I'm going to add social media. So you can see that now I've got all of these pages in here. And you can also add a URL. So if I want to link to Rollins's main site, I could do that. And then if I want to open that in the same page, or if I want to open it in a new window, I can do that. I'm going to leave it at the same page, because I really hate it when sites open things in new windows all the time. So click on OK. And then you can choose from boxes, and you can see what that looks like, to tabs or to links. And I like boxes and tabs. You can see the change here. I'll leave it at boxes so you can see. So right now I've got boxes. If I edit those and change it to tabs, you'll see that it basically looks like they're folder tabs, etc. Links I don't usually like, but boxes I'm gonna leave it there. Okay, so that gives me a bit here, right? So I'm gonna close this. But I still need some more pages here, because I don't want to just have like a basic page of research, a basic page of social media, a basic page for, well, Rollins, of course, is an external link, so I'm not going to worry about that. So I'm going to add another page, and I'm going to go to, I'm going to make a books page for my books. And I'm going to put this somewhere else. I'm going to put this, so I'm going to leave it as a web page, and I'm going to choose a different location. I'm going to put this under research. Okay, that's good. Create. Now notice what happens here is that my sidebar, or my my horizontal bar, is not actually going to change. But my when I scroll over that, it should give me a bit of a drop-down menu. And so the way I do that is I go to edit site layout again. And then I can edit my horizontal navigation, and you can see that I need to add the page here, and I want to add books. Okay, and then I can move that up to research, and I can move it over so that it's under research. And then so what happens here is that I can go back to and close this. When I roll over research, the link pops down. So clicking on research will send me to this main page, and maybe that would be some discussion about my research and research interests. But then if I click on books, it'll give me maybe images and a couple of descriptions of my current books. So that's really how you work with site structure. And notice that there's a whole bunch of things that you can do within this, right? So when you're in site layout, you can take off different pieces of this. So right now we've got the header, but maybe we want to change our footer a little bit. So we can edit the footer, or we can edit the regular system footer. So maybe I'll take out the custom, but I'll edit the system footer, and I can actually remove all of these different pieces here if I want to. So let's say I want to remove my recent changes link and print page link, just so that it's a little bit more usable. Notice that there's a couple of things that you can't actually do here. You can't actually remove the report abuse, remove access, or powered by Google Sites link. So this is always going to be there on the page, but that's not really a big deal. So when we close this, this is what you really need to be thinking about doing, is to actually create a structure that makes sense for your project, and that would be external links as well as internal links, to actually have sublinks, subpages within those, and then to have the main page look the way you want it to look in terms of basic structure. So I would say actually edit these pages and put some things into them, just as placeholders to let us know what's going to happen here. And then with a later practicum, we're going to actually go through and edit your images and all of that. So really think about your structure, really think about the navigation, and how this plays into your story. Good luck.